The Airbus A350 is among the industry's most modern twin-engined widebody airliners. Known for its composite design, Airbus first proposed the airframe in 2004 as a major competitor of the Boeing 787 Dreamliner program. The A330 was essentially the foundation for early concepts of the aircraft, but as time evolved and Airbus received feedback from the industry, it developed a new cleansheet design, marketing the plane as XWB, which stands for extra wide body. The aircraft would also receive its own exclusive engine, the Rolls-Royce Trent XWB. In today's video, we look at some basic history of the aircraft and offer several reasons why the A350 is as popular as it is. Some reasons will be rather obvious and could apply to any aircraft of its size, while other reasons may be less well known. Designed as a long-range airplane, sized between the 787 and 777 families of aircraft, the A350 has several advancements in passenger experience and comfort. However, it's not just upgrades in the cabin that make it an enjoyable aircraft. Numerous pilots have praised Airbus for its improvements to cockpit features that make it safer and easier to fly. Development of the first A350 as a clean sheet design began in 2008 and series production started in 2010. The aircraft type has two variants, the A350-900 and the stretched -1000 variant. There was a -800 proposed, but low interest in the variant prompted Airbus to scrap the idea. Qatar Airways became the launch customer of the aircraft when the first -900 variant was delivered in December 2014. On January 15, 2015, the airline flew its first A350 flight between Doha and Frankfurt. The A350-1000 took its first flight in November 2016. However, it would be close to 2 years before it was delivered. Qatar was also the first carrier to operate the -1000, debuting it on commercial service from Doha to London in February 2018. The first thing to love about the Airbus A350 is its internal altitude or cabin pressure of 6,000 feet, approximately 1,830 meters. The A350 was Airbus's first aircraft to be made of carbon fiber reinforced polymers. According to Slashgear, more than 70% of its construction utilizes composite materials, titanium, and modern aluminium alloys. This forms an extremely robust fuselage, which allows for increased cabin pressurization. Regardless of the aircraft's physical altitude, whether at 35,000 feet or 43,000 feet, the pressure in the cabin matches the elevation of 6,000 feet, which ultimately helps alleviate fatigue and the effects of jet lag. And staying on the topic of the cabin, the interior is also quieter and, of course, wider, which provides more comfort. According to Aircraft Interiors International, the A350's cabin width is 18 feet 5 inches or 5.61 meters, about 5 inches over the 787's cabin width. Airbus recently introduced a new A350 cabin design known as NPS or New Production Standard, which offers an extra 4 inches. The side walls have been redesigned to create an additional 2 inches on each side of the cabin. While they increase the cabin width further, they also feature uprated insulation to ensure that the aircraft's acoustic and thermal insulation properties remain unchanged. Of course, one big exception to its extra wide-body comfort is when airlines squeeze in a 10th seat into each row of their economy class cabins. Somewhat lesser-known airlines like French Bee and Air Caraibes have set up their cabins like this, but it's also expected that Philippine Airlines will do this for its A350-1000s when they enter service. And so while this type of cabin density is not ideal for passengers, the fact that it's possible has certainly made some airlines happy. For people outside of the aircraft, it's quieter as well. According to the UK Civil Aviation Authority, the A350 is on average up to 6 decibels quieter on departure than the A330 and 777, and up to 9 decibels quieter than the A340. It was also confirmed that the A350 is up to 3 decibels quieter on arrival than the aircraft types it's intended to replace. The aircraft's engines aren't just quieter, they're more efficient. More efficient engines paired with a lighter airframe and advanced avionics and aerodynamics allow the A350 to consume less fuel. Yes, while next-generation fuel efficiency is something every new aircraft strives for, it certainly is a strong foundation for A350 popularity. The type is 20% more efficient than older planes. According to Cathay Pacific, which also is an A350 operator, the aircraft burns 25% less fuel than most previous generation aircraft, meaning fewer carbon emissions. Thanks to the A350 and other new aircraft within its fleet, Cathay boasts that it has managed to reduce its fuel burn by 28% over the last 26 years. Perhaps this is not too surprising when considering all the technological advancements over those many years, but it's good to keep in mind that the airline's fleet has grown significantly over those years as well. One of the most notable features that makes the A350 a favorite among pilots is its cockpit design. As explained by Airbus, the aircraft was, quote, designed by pilots for pilots. From the plane's conception, Airbus pilots took part in the design of its cockpit. It comes with 6 identical large screens, which allow for enhanced visibility of pertinent information across the cockpit. The screens also provide extended interactivity for the pilots. The screens are also designed to reduce overall pilot workload while increasing situational awareness. Additionally, the cockpit was developed with the physical comfort and practicality of pilots in mind, as the space also features retractable tray tables, reclining seat backrests with lumbar adjustment, adjustable armrests and headrests, and increased head-up display or HUD head clearance. And finally, the last reason for the A350's popularity is something that both pilots and airlines will love, a common type rating with the A330 family of aircraft, whether the jets are from the CEO or NEO generation. Pilots of the A330CO/NEO can qualify to fly the A350 in 8 training days without full flight simulator time, and then be eligible to operate both aircraft under a single license endorsement known as SFF, or Single Fleet Flying. Beyond the common type rating, the A350 cockpit has similarities with other Airbus aircraft. This is because the jet has been developed under the same fly-by-wire philosophy as other Airbus jets, and offers similar flight deck layouts. This allows airlines to implement cross-crew qualifications for A320 family aircraft, A340s, and A380s with durations of 11, 10, and 5 days of training, respectively. This commonality also allows airlines to facilitate mixed flying, which increases productivity and greater flexibility. This feature benefits carriers such as Delta Airlines, which uses many examples of the A330 and A350 to support its long-haul network. So, that's our list of reasons for why the Airbus A350 has become the popular aircraft that it is. Have you ever flown on the A350? Be sure to share your experiences with us by leaving a comment below. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.